A lot of people mistake prolonging a lucid dream for staying asleep. Two different separate things. First of all, you can't stay asleep all the time. So if your main goal for prolonging lucid dreaming is for you to be in a 24-hour lucid dream, it's not going to happen. Your body will wake up eventually. It will happen. And there's nothing you can do about that. Prolonging lucid dreaming is less about trying to stay asleep and more about trying to maintain consciousness in your dream. So for example, a really good way of prolonging lucid dreaming is to stabilize your dream. And I've had a few experiences with stabilizing my dream. There's two main things that I use in order to stabilize a dream. There's the rubbing the hands together, and then there's trying to invoke as many senses as you can. One of my experiences with rubbing my hands together, I'm there, I'm in a dream, it's a few years back, I'm rubbing my hands together. I don't do it often anymore, but when I did, it worked. But I was rubbing my hands together because I hear from a lot of other people that rubbing your hands together seems to have a weird effect on the dream world. So I was trying it to see what would happen. I was rubbing my hands together and all the colors seemed to like pulse, so to speak. It was like, and all the dream world was like pulsing every time I was rubbing my hands. I thought it was quite interesting. Now, is that because I was thinking that something was going to happen, but wasn't sure what was going to happen? Or is that just because that's what happens with me? I don't know. But the experience itself, it happened, and that's all that really matters. The second thing that I use quite often in lucid dreaming to stabilize my dream, or to prolong my dream anyway, is invoke as many senses as you can. You got touch, taste, smell, sound, sight. And we already use sight and sound quite a lot in lucid dreaming or in dreams in general. But it's the other senses that need to be invoked in order to stabilize a dream, to like maintain order on the dream, so to speak. So you're there in your dream and you're like grabbing the wall. Your brain becomes less clouded. I think that's the best way to describe it. My brain became less clouded. And instead of losing my lucidity, I'm able to prolong my lucidity just because I'm stabilizing my dream. So the best one I've ever had, and I've explained it before in the past, is this time that I was, I couldn't see anything in a dream. And I'm thinking, oh, this is a great time to experiment with touch in a lucid dream, because I was messing around with the senses back then. So because I couldn't see anything, I thought, oh, great, I'll just mess around. So I was feeling all these things, and then I felt a wall. In this dream, I'm there, I'm touching the wall, and then I feel at the top, and there's glass at the top. It doesn't hurt or anything, it doesn't cut you because it's like smoothish, but I knew exactly where I was. In relation to waking life, I knew that I was next to this wall in my neighborhood. And I extended the levels of lucidity because simply that I was just touching the wall. If I weren't to do stabilization techniques or anything, I would have woken up and I would have lost my lucid dream, or I would have just faded out into non-conscious dreaming. There are probably more ways you can expand your lucidity or prolong a lucid dream. But as I said before, there's a difference between prolonging a lucid dream and trying to stay asleep. There are other things you can do, like spinning around in a circle, which is also linked to senses, because you've got like proprioception, which is another sense that we use. And just basically trying to invoke as many senses works for me and a few others. And sometimes it has weird effects like teleportation or seeing the colors vibrate as you rub your hands or other weird stuff like that. So the top five video on alien reptiles went really well, surprisingly. And if you're interested in joining the conversation about the top five alien reptilian thoughts that I had through my head, then I'm planning on doing a live stream on the 1st of October, 9 a.m, which is a Saturday, UK time. So if you're around or awake, I don't know what you're doing, please join me. And until next time.